delicious.
Good morning, Tom Spellman with Dave Wilson Nursery. It's July 8th, it's a beautiful day here in the San Joaquin Valley, and we're out here at one of my absolute favorite places, Zaiger Genetics in Modesto, California. For those of you that have followed us, followed Dave Wilson Nursery, you know that we're one of the licensed growers for Zaigers here in the Central Valley and throughout the southwestern United States. And we're really proud of our relationship with Zaigers. We're really lucky to be able to have access to such a wonderful collection of fruit varieties, interspecifics, nut trees, and Floyd Zaiger and his family have just done an incredible job of releasing spectacular varieties. Now, for a fruit geek like me, a trip to Zaiger's is like taking your 12-year-old to Disneyland. This is just about as much fun as I'll have in the fruit world this summer. So what we'll do today is we'll go through, we'll follow Floyd, we'll follow the family. We're going through with some fruit enthusiasts and growers from all over the world. We'll taste new and experimental varieties, and we'll talk to some of the people that are involved in fruit growing, fruit marketing, and fruit hybridization. So let's take a look at what we've got. This is Robert Woolley. Robert is the owner of Dave Wilson Nursery and also a real fruit aficionado. He's spent many, many, many Wednesdays out here on the walkthroughs and is always looking for something new and unique. What's looking good today, Robert? What are we looking for today?
Well, we're looking for any high flavor stone fruit out of the breeding program. My charge that I've given myself is to find the highest flavor material and to plant it at Dave Wilson Nursery for possible use in either the home garden arena or in the kind of crossover group of fruit stand and pick your own operations.
Absolutely. And we were looking at the experimental block at the nursery yesterday, and boy, there's some really nice varieties in there. I mean, and each and every one was just, you know, a bomb as far as flavor.
They were so good. Group
yes.
I brought over
the first initial group
strictly on the flavor characteristics.
Right.
And I'm happy that we're hitting about 75% of those are panning out to be good solid varieties for backyard or for farmers market.
And what were we talking about yesterday? You know, now Dave Wilson Nursery gets the opportunity to work with the best of the new developments along with reintroducing the best of what was here 100 years ago. Some of these varieties...
I'm trying to promote a slogan. It hasn't caught on yet, but we're looking for the best of the new and old.
Absolutely. I think that's a wonderful slogan. And Robert, I appreciate everything that you do and all the opportunities that you've allowed me in working with Dave Wilson over the years, and I look forward to a great future with the company and with you.
Igualmente.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
This is Eric Wool. He's Research and Development Director with a local company here in the Valley, Family Tree Farm. And you guys farm how many acres of fresh fruit, Eric?
Approximately 4,000 acres.
So you're out here almost every Wednesday. Every Wednesday that I've been here, you've been here.
Right.
You're looking for the best of the best and new varieties and just whatever is really exciting. What have you seen today that's impressive?
Well, I've seen some pluots today that have really caught my attention. Very high bricks, good texture, good flavor, some wonderful stuff today.
Absolutely. This midsummer season always seems to really bring out the best of the best.
It's the best time of the year for fruit.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Eric.
You're welcome.
This is Dennis Terry. He's president and CEO of Dave Wilson Nursery, also a fruit and nut grower, farmer on the side. And Dennis has been just a real driving force in all the wonderful things that have happened here at Dave Wilson Nursery. So, Dennis, just give me a few words of wisdom and you know, tell me what you're looking for out here today.
Well, I'm just looking for high-flavored fruit that has got some commercial quality that we can get to the markets that our customers serve. Looking for innovations and uniqueness. I think that there's market niches that need to be filled, and I'm trying to spot those and help our customers get the product that they need.
Absolutely. Looking at some of those niche times, you know, when we can fit a variety that's not available into a new week or 2 week period, or looking for new flavors and new colors and new types of fruit is just such a great experience out here. I look forward to every time I can come out and spend a few hours here.
It's always an adventure.
Thank you, Dennis.
Thank you.
I'm here with Leo Buck, co-director of Common Vision. And Common Vision is one of the organizations that we've worked with over the years in distributing trees out to schools, specifically schools, I believe, isn't it, Leo?
Yeah, indeed.
Yeah, why don't you tell us a little bit about what you're doing at Common Vision?
Yeah, so we've been partnering with Dave Wilson Nursery for quite a few years. We plant and maintain fruit tree orchards at schools all across the state. So we're in 215 schools, all the way from San Diego all the way up to Chico, with anywhere from 15 to, at our biggest sites, 150. Fruit trees.
The
kids take part in the planting, they take part in the maintenance, they take part in the harvest. The fruit goes either to the cafeteria or the after school snack, and we're getting healthy food and some nutrition education in a ton of schools.
It's such a worthwhile effort. You know, it's so important that we bring agriculture and horticulture back into our schools so that, you know, children understand where does your fruit come from and you know, how does this tree grow. And it was something that I think we lost for decades.
Yeah.
And it's so nice to see it coming back, and it's so nice to see all the valuable work that you're doing with the schools around town.
Indeed.
Thank you so much.
And we couldn't do it without y'all.
Well, we appreciate it. This is Stacy Anderson. She's one of our commercial sales reps in the San Joaquin Valley, and Stacy is a loyal follower of Zaiger varieties and is here probably almost every Wednesday through the summer, Stacy.
Every Wednesday.
So tell us a little bit about what you're looking for today and what's exciting in the world of commercial fruit tree sales.
We're always looking for flavor. We're looking for good crop on the trees. We're looking for anything, a variance of different fruits from the pluots, apriums, peaches, nectarines, even a little bit of the cling peach market at this point in time. Always looking for that unique flavor, making sure that the tree has lots of fruit, good size. Color is important for the commercial venue.
Absolutely. You know, and one of the unique things about this Zaiger block here is pretty much every tree on this acreage is a different variety, and there's just so many wonderful varieties out here. When you look at diversity and size and shape and color and flavors, there's a little bit of everything out here, and it's just an honor to be able to come out and go through and try all these unique varieties.
That's true, Tom. There's a lot of variation out here, and some days it's very difficult to distinguish which one of these special fruits we should actually launch and put out on the market. So it makes our job very difficult the more types of fruit that we have and what is actually going to be make it into the commercial variety.
Absolutely.
Commercial markets. So.
And thanks for being here, and thanks for all you do, Stacy.
You're welcome. Thank you, Tom.
This is Phil Purcell, and Phil is one of our Branch 40 sales representatives for Dave Wilson Nursery, as well as I am. So my territory is Southern California, Arizona, Southern Nevada. Phil picks up on the Central Coast and in the Central Valley where my territory ends. So Phil does all of Central California up. How far north, Phil?
So I go through Central California, the Bay Area, all the way up into the Grass Valley area, Northern Nevada.
And you know, Phil is here like I'm here. We're looking really for the best of the best in what we can come up with for home garden varieties that we can sell through retail and wholesale nurseries so that the general public has the opportunity to taste the best varieties of fruit that they can possibly get.
So a good example right now, we've gone through probably about 15 varieties. I've starred one as something possible as a candidate going forward to look into a little bit more. We are very choosy.
We are. We are. Absolutely. We're looking for the what we would consider the best of the best.
Right.
We want it to look good. We want it to taste good. We want it to be a good size fruit, good color. You know, all of those things are important. But really, what's the most important thing?
It's just taste.
It's just taste.
It's taste.
But, you know, if it tastes good, I really don't care what it looks like. I don't care if it's big or small. I don't care if it has a seed. None of those things really matter to me. If it tastes good, I want to eat it.
Yeah.
All right, number 338LU366.
Isn't that the last one?
No, it was 331LU346.
Close enough.
Very close. First bricks is 19.
That was this one?
Mm-hmm.
This is my good friend Leith Gardner. Leith is Floyd Zaiger's daughter and one of the driving forces here at Zaiger Hybrids. So Leith, I know you're out here religiously every Wednesday on the walkthroughs, and I can't tell you how much I appreciate an opportunity to be here and go through this with you guys. What have you seen today that is really impressive to you?
Well, there's been a couple of the pluots that I think are a lot of potential, both in the consumer or commercial end and the home garden end, that have super high flavor that I think has the potential to be up-and-coming varieties.
And that's really what we're here for, is to look and decide what the next generation of commercial fruit is going to be. What's going to be available on the market, what's going to be popular, why it's going to be popular. So we just get a great opportunity to go through and look at all these wonderful varieties and taste some incredible fruit. Leith, again, thank you so much. I really, really enjoy working with you guys, and I just can't tell you what a good opportunity it is for Dave Wilson Nursery and Zaiger's both to be involved in this.
Well, it's our pleasure, and we hope we'll have a continuing lot of fruit to look at for the years to come.
Oh, I'm sure we will. Thanks. Let's go eat some fruit. This is Katie Amaral. She is our marketing manager at Dave Wilson Nursery. Katie's been with us how many years now?
Six
years, and you have been a loyal participant in the Wednesday Zaiger tours. So what are you looking for out here?
Usually what I'm looking for are varieties that we're going to fast track, and I make sure that we mark them, and then Mike and I come back and make sure that we document them.
This is the magic list right here. So this is the list they call the cream of the crop list. It's all the varieties that we're looking at today. And what's on here today, about 30 some varieties?
Yeah, I think so.
So we're just going from tree to tree, evaluating each tree, each fruit variety, and their varieties that were selected earlier in the week as being at peak commercial ripeness today. And we've really had some pretty spectacular pieces of fruit. What was your favorite today, Katie?
I would have to say Bella Cat so far.
Yeah, really nice. Really mm-hmm. nice flavor, nice texture, nice color. It's one of those varieties that has pretty much everything going for it.
I would agree.
Hey, thank you so much, Katie. Always a pleasure working with you. This is Hannah Lenz. She is a summer intern at Dave Wilson Nursery. She's a Cal Poly San Luis Obispo senior, and we're really happy to have her out here this summer. She's working directly with Robert on some of our other projects, our high fruit flavor evaluation project. I know you've been here now, what, 2-3 weeks, Hannah?
This is my second week.
This is your second week and your second trip out to Zaiger's?
Yes.
And you'll get many more through the season.
Yes.
What's your opinion of what's going on here? What do you think?
I haven't seen anything like this. I absolutely love it out here. I didn't realize, I didn't have an idea of what this would be like, but I didn't realize there'd be so many different varieties all together in 140 acres. It's just...
It's almost hard for most people to comprehend that we've got somewhere in the range of 150, maybe 200,000 varieties out here, all under evaluations, all cataloged hybrids that, you know, the maternal parent and the pollinating parent have all been documented, and to look at this many fruit in this small space has just been incredible for me. I always, and I've already said in the video earlier that, you know, for me, as a fruit geek, a trip to Zaiger's like a 10-year-old kid's trip
definitely,
to Disneyland, you know,
definitely,
so it's just fun to be involved in it and really an honor to be out here and get an opportunity to work with all this.
Yes, it's been
Hannah,
a great opportunity.
Thank you so much. I can't thank you enough for working with us at Dave Wilson Nursery, and we look forward to a good, fruitful future.
Definitely, me too. I love it.
Good. This is a good friend of mine, a long-term employee with Dave Wilson Nursery, Harbir Singh. And Harbir is worked in our propagation and greenhouse division for several years. What, five, six, 7 years maybe?
No, about 9 years.
9 years.
Yes.
And Harbir has recently been promoted to a commercial sales reps position in the northern San Joaquin Valley. So you're selling both fruit trees and almonds and walnuts.
Yes.
And
almonds, walnuts, everything. Fresh market fruit, fresh market fruit, dry fruit, everything.
Right, right. And you know, I've worked with Harbir many, many times over the years, and in fruit evaluations at the nursery, and he's got a good palate for fruit. He's got a good judge of what tastes good and what looks good. And
when I was hired for a fruit evaluator. So.
Absolutely, I remember that. You know,
I was hired as a fruit evaluator, and that's where.
Yeah, you and the guy behind the camera used to go out and evaluate fruit all the time. So. I think Mr. Tomlinson taught you pretty well, didn't he?
Yeah, he did.
He's got a pretty good taste for fruit, too.
Yeah.
But just wanted to say hi, and thanks for being with us, Harbir.
Thank you.
Really appreciate everything you're doing.
Appreciate you, too.
This is the man. This is Floyd Zaiger. How many years in fruit breeding, Floyd?
Oh, 53 or 4.
53 or 54 years in fruit breeding, and the accomplishments that I've seen out here over the years are just incredible. I just love the opportunity to come out here with you and your family and walk through and look at some of these, you know, incredible varieties. They just have all of the great characteristics of a wonderful piece of fruit, you know, whether it's color or shape or flavor or, you know, size. I mean, you've just done such a fantastic job of breeding varieties over the years. I can't tell you how much I personally appreciate it, and the fruit eating world should appreciate it. You really have changed the way that fruit has been grown around the world. What's really important out here today? What's really looking good to you today?
Oh, we have some good-looking nectarines and peaches.
Yeah.
Plums and apricots.
Yeah, and you know, for the almost mid-July to get some of these apricot varieties today. Good size, good flavor, good texture. Just some incredible apricot and apricot hybrids out here today.
Yeah, we'll have apricots up through September.
Yeah, I know you will, and that's a whole new deal for apricots. I mean, 10 years ago, nobody would have even considered an apricot after this time of the season. Yeah. You know, late July, August, September apricots were non-existent. So, like I said, you've done a great job of changing the fruit world and the way that varieties are looked at and the seasons that varieties can be marketed. And you know, Floyd, I can't thank you enough, sir.
Well,
it's a pleasure to work with you.
We work hard and we work consistently and we never give up.
And you know, that's the key. This man has done hundreds of thousands of crosses over the years, and I know personally that Mr. Zaiger still works. You work pretty much 7 days a week, don't you?
Yeah, they're up there.
And sometimes, you know, you might work 12, 15 hours a day, and that's dedication to something that he's loved over the years, and the results have sure been proof positive of all the effort that you've put into it. Thank you so much, Floyd.
Well, the older you get, well, the less time you work, but then that's part of the program.
Yeah, but every time I'm here, I still see you out here and still see you very much involved in the day-to-day operations and evaluations of what you're doing. And that, like I said, that really, really shows and makes a difference.
Well, thank you.
Thank you. You know, we're just finishing off our last test varieties here today. We've evaluated about 35 different varieties of fruit. Some really, really cool stuff today. And it's, you know, like I've mentioned earlier in the video, it's always a great opportunity for me to come out here and be able to do this walkthrough and hang with some really, really key fruit people in the industry and just enjoy a great day out in the orchard here in Modesto. One of the things that I didn't mention, and I think it's important and worth mentioning, is that everything that Zaiger's is hybridizing is non-GMO, no genetic modification of any kind. What they're doing here at Zaiger's are hybrids. So they're taking a maternal parent in bloom, like a plum, and they're pollinating that plum flower with apricot pollen, and they're growing on the progeny. So they're growing on the crosses. And these are evaluated for all the characteristics that they're looking for. Is it early? Is it late? Is it self-fruitful? Is it a big fruit? Is it disease resistance? They're trying to breed in all these characteristics by using the right mother and father combination. And most of these hybrids are not what we would call an F1, which is just plum by apricot. Most of them are, you know, plum by apricot, by plum, by plum, by apricot, by plum, or whatever, to come up with the right combination that they're looking for. So F5, F6, F7 series hybrids are coming out of production here. So it's not something that happens in a season or two seasons. It really takes decades. In fact, it takes no less than 14 years worth of breeding and evaluation to release a new variety. But you know, the most important consideration when you look at a pluot or an aprium and think, well, is that genetically modified somehow? It's not. There's nothing in that hybrid cross that wouldn't naturally occur if the two varieties were growing in the same area in nature. So all they're doing is enhancing what nature would do over time. So what nature could take 20,000 years to do, Zaiger's can do in two decades. So, you know, feel confident that Zaiger hybrids are not genetically modified, that they're good, old-fashioned, hybrid fruit varieties, that, you know, this type of hybridization has been going on for 100 years or more. Luther Burbank was the first hybridizer that was growing the first plumcot variety, you know, in California 120 years ago. So feel comfortable that what you're eating is not genetically modified, but a good quality hybrid fruit that has the best characteristics of both parent or several parents. Tom Spellman with Dave Wilson Nursery. Enjoy your fruit trees this summer. Eat fresh fruit as often as you can. Thanks for watching.